Hello, myself Girish Belkar, and I welcome you to Math Made Easy Class 9 Mathematics. Today we are going to learn about circles. Circles are everywhere, and we are used to circles that we do not notice them in our daily lives. Pizzas, roti, wheels of vehicles, bangles, dials of many clocks, coins, key rings, buttons of shirts, all are nothing but circles. For 1,000 years, human beings have been fascinated by circles since they first looked toward the sun and moon, which looked circular. Humans have created circular monuments to nature, built over 4,000 years ago to the Stonehenge in the England is the geometrical alignment of the stones in the form of concentric circles, which have served as ancient astronomical calculator and calendar. The most famous circular invention, one that has credited the most important invention of all, is the wheel. Scholars as early as Socrates and Plato have been fascinated with sheer beauty of properties of circles, and many scholars made a life's work out of studying them. Euclid was probably the most famous of these. It is in circle geometry that concept of congruence studied earlier have a powerful context. Learning objectives of this module are: after completion of this module, you will be able to define circle and its related terms, prove properties of circles related to arcs, chords, and angles subtended by them, explain properties of cyclic quadrilateral, solve simple problem based on the circles and its properties. Circles and its related term. You have studied circle in earlier classes and you know how to draw a circle. To draw a circle, we take compass and put the pin of this compass at one point and rotate the tip of pencil, and this way we complete the circle. So what exactly is happening here is the tip of the pin is a fixed point and the tip of pencil is a moving point. So when you move this tip of pencil, what happens? The distance between tip of pin and the tip of pencil remains constant, and this is what is the definition of circle: a collection of all points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from a fixed point in the plane, and this is called a circle. The fixed point is called the center of the circle, and the fixed distance is called radius of the circle. A circle divides the plane on which it lies into three parts: the interior of the circle, which is inside, the circle, the boundary of the circle, which is circle itself, and the exterior of the circle. If you take two points A and B on the circle and join them, you get a chord AB. You can see in the figure AB is a chord of the circle. The chord which passes through the center of the circle is called diameter. In the figure, CD is a chord which is passing through the center of the circle, therefore it is a diameter. Now we know that from a point, given point, we can draw infinitely many lines, and since O is a point, center of the circle, we can draw infinitely many chords passing through O, and therefore you have infinitely many diameters of a circle. A piece of circle between two points is called an arc. In the figure, you can see that the two points AB divide the circle into two parts. The smaller part is called minor arc, and the bigger part is called major arc. The region between a chord and either of its arc is called a segment of the circle. The region enclosed by the minor arc and the chord is known as minor segment, and the region enclosed between major arc and the chord is called major segment. The region between arc and the two radii joining the center to the end points of the arc is called sector. In the figure, you can see that OA and OB are the radii of the circles and AB is a arc. So this arc is minor arc, therefore the area enclosed is called minor sector, and the area enclosed by these two radii and the major arc AB is called major sector. Now we come to angle subtended by a chord at a point. So before this, we need to know what is angle subtended by a line segment at a point. For this, let us take a line segment PQ and a point R outside it. Join PR and QR. then the angle at R is called angle subtended by PQ at R. So, in this case, the angle PRQ is the angle subtended by the chord PQ at the point R. Now, let us explore the relationship between the length of the chord and the angle subtended by it at the center. In the figure, you can see that AB and CD are two chords of different length. The length of chord AB is bigger than length of chord CD. Now, let us change the chord of CD. So, what happens as the length of chord CD is less than length of chord AB, the angle subtended by the chord CD at the center is less than the angle subtended by the chord AB. Let us increase the length of chord CD. So, now you see that the length of chord CD is bigger than the length of chord AB, and therefore, the angle subtended by the chord at the center is bigger than AB. So, no matter wherever I take this chord AB, the length is always less than CD, and therefore, the angle which is subtended by AB is 142 degree, whereas the angle subtended by chord CD is 143, and the length you can see is 6.9 and 7.02. So, we see that the bigger chord subtends bigger angle at the center and the smaller chord subtends smaller angle at the center. But what happens if the both chords are equal length? That is, what is the relation between angle subtended by equal chord at the center? Let us explore that. So, in the figure, chord AB and chord CD are of the same length, and right now you can see that both subtends equal angle at the center, that is 86 degree. Let us move this point. So, if I change the position of chord CD, the angle is not changing. See, still the length of chord CD is equal to length of chord AB. Let us increase the size of the circle. So, even if I increase the size, you see that if the chords are equal, then the angle subtended by them are also equal. We can increase this length of AB, and simultaneously the length of CD is also increasing, and in each case both the chords are of same length, and therefore angle subtended by them at the center are equal. So, we can conclude that equal chord subtends equal angle at the center. This statement we have just verified, but verification does not substitute the proof. So, we need to prove this theorem as well. So, let us proceed to prove this theorem. So, let us take a circle with two chords AB and CD that are equal. Join AO and OB, OC and OD. So, we have two triangles AOB and COD. Now, in triangle AOB and triangle COD, what we have, AB is equal to CD, which is given to us because the chords AB and CD are equal. OB is equal to OD because they are radii of the same circle. Similarly, we have OA is equal to OC, also the radii. So, in triangle AOB and COD, what we have is corresponding sides are equal. Therefore, by SS congruency rule, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COD. What does that mean? That means the angle AOB is equal to angle COD because they are corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So, we have proved the theorem that equal chord subtends equal angle at the center. Now, let us move towards, if the chord subtends equal angle at the center, then what is the relation between them? We have seen that the equal chord subtends equal angle at the center, but this is the converse of that result, that if chord subtends equal angle at the center, are they equal? Let us verify. In this figure, you can see that there are two chords AB and CD. AB subtends an angle of 54 degree, whereas CD subtends an angle of 101 degree. With the help of the slider, we will change the angle subtended by the chord CD at the center, and let us see what happens to the length of the chord CD as it reaches the angle 54. So, you see that as soon as the angle becomes 54 degree, the length of chord CD becomes equal to the length of chord AB. Let us try another. So, we will generate angle AOB. Let us change the angle AOB. So, now angle AOB has become 82 degree. Now, change angle COD and see what happens. Again, we see that as soon as angle AOB becomes equal to angle COD, then the length of chord AB is equal to length of chord CD. Let us try one another time. Now, the angle AOB is 45 degree. We will make angle COD also 45 degree by the slider. So, now angle COD is 45 degree, and you can see that chord CD is equal to chord AB. So, we can conclude if the angle subtended by two chords at the center are equal, then the length of the chords are also equal. But again, we need to prove this statement. So, let us proceed towards the proof. Again, we draw a circle with two chords AB and CD which subtends equal angle at the center. That means, this time the angle AOB and angle COD are equal. So, again in triangle AOB and COD, angle AOB is equal to angle COD because this is given to us. OB is equal to OD, radii of the circle, and OA is equal to OC, also radii of the circle. So, now you see that in triangle AOB and triangle COD, two sides OB and OA are equal to OD and OC respectively, and an angle included between these two sides is also equal. So, therefore, by SAS congruency rule, triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COD. So, therefore, we have AB is equal to CD by CPCT, that is congruent parts of congruence triangle. Now, we move to an interesting fact. Have you ever wondered that the area of right angle triangle can be associated with area of circle? I am sure you haven't. So, let us see what is the relation between these two geometrical objects. Archimedes, which lives in the year 287 to 212 BC, proposed that the area of a circle was equal to the area of a right triangle whose legs have length equal to the radius r and the circumference c of a circle. Thus, A, which is area of the right triangle, is equal to half r into c. He used indirect proof and the areas of inscribed and circumscribed polygons to prove his conjecture, and to prove that the value of pi actually lies between 3 integer 10 by 17 and 3 integer 1 by 7. If we convert both the sides of pi into decimal, we get this inequality, which can be written as 3.14085 is less than pi, and pi is less than 3.142857. So, Archimedes' approximation was correct to two decimal places. Isn't it an interesting fact? So, we can see that the geometrical figures are not isolated, but they are interrelated with each other. So, that's all for today. But before going, we'll recap what we have learned. So, we have learned about circles and the terms related to it. We also learn that the angles subtended by equal chords at the center are equal, and the converse of this is also true. That means, if the chord subtends equal angle at the center, then they are equal. Thank you.